you're saying my name.
Luna! Luna! Luna!
Hey everybody, I'm Mary.
And I'm Joe.
And we're Book Buds!
Today we're going to be talking about The Girl Who Drank the Moon by Kelly Barnhill. It won the Newbery Medal in 2017 for Best Book. This book tells about a town who sacrifices a baby every year to keep a witch happy. Yes, it's very unfortunate for the family that gives up that child. They are not happy. The witch comes and she knows nothing of this bargain, and she thinks, why are these people throwing these babies away? And she comes to save the babies each year. And so one year she finds Luna, who she has this fondness for, and she develops love for her. So she decides to raise Luna as her own child. Now, typically the children that she saves, they drink from the stars. This is a fantasy book. It's filled with witchcraft and magic beings.
Love that.
So the children typically drink from the stars. However, she makes a mistake and Luna drinks from the moon. So when Luna drinks from the moon, she then has all these very, like an excessive amount of magic that needs to be contained, because when she's walking, there are flowers blooming, and she's a child. She doesn't know how to keep it in control. If she's angry, she could hurt someone. So her magic gets bound until she's 13, at which time the witch, who she believes is her grandmother, will pass away when her Luna's magic returns to her. So you know this throughout the story. You learn this pretty early on as the reader. It sets it up to be a really fantastic book. So this book is a really well-renowned book. It was recommended to us by our elementary school librarian for anybody who loves Harry Potter. So my daughter and I thought for sure we were going to love this book. So we did this as a read aloud together. But when we were reading it, the style, the language was a little abstract. There were some times that there was some poetic language kind of used, and there were some chapters that were just brief chapters written in all italics, and it was another speaker maybe telling a story to a child. And it just kind of took you away from the story too frequently that it felt a little disjointed. My 11-year-old daughter and I were really excited about the magical aspects of this. There were cute, there's a cute little tiny dragon who thought he was a fierce, enormous dragon in the book. And
the premise sounds amazing.
It is. It's a great,
sounds really good.
Great storyline, and so much more could have been done with it. The cute little dragon my daughter loved. There was a swamp creature that my daughter loves. The characters were great, but the story itself was just, the story itself didn't go the place I wanted it to go. So you guys know when you get to that last sliver of a book, when the action is building and you're thinking, oh, there's gonna be a major scene here. Well, in this book, there's the building, you're thinking, oh my goodness, her magic's coming back to her. The grandmother witch is dying. The town is gonna be obliterated. Something terrible's gonna happen. And no joke, it cuts from that to saying, after the attack, and all of a sudden,
They skip the action?
They totally skip the action. And you were just left in the aftermath of the action. And it just, you know, just chunked it. Gone. No action at all.
So, interesting choice.
Yeah. That right there destroyed it for me. I kept reading the book thinking, I'm going to enjoy this, even though the style and the language I'm not really loving. I was into the story enough that I was like, you know, something good will come from this. When they cut the action like that, I was really done with the book at that point. And I stopped and I pointed it out to my daughter, since I was reading aloud, I pointed it out to her and I said, you realize we just skipped all the action. She's like, why did that happen? You know, it was strange. Mm. So then we get to the end of the book, and we had thought, both my daughter and I thought, that the grandmother witch was going to die immediately when the magic came back, and she hadn't died for chapters and chapters, had not died. And so then she kind of like dies poetically at the end, and the swamp creature carries the witch grandmother off into the bog, and that's her death. And it was so abstractly written that when I finished the very last page, I turned and I looked at my daughter, and she looked at me and she said, what?
What happened?
That was her word. What? So you don't want a book to end that way, in my opinion, where you're just left with like, huh? Well, I don't really get it.
What did I just read?
Yes.
Yeah, that's not fun.
So when it was all said and done, because the action scene was cut and because of the weird abstract ending, I just decided I did not like this book and I really wouldn't recommend it to anybody. But then I asked my 11-year-old, so what'd you think? You know what she said? I loved it, Mom. It was filled with magic.
You have it.
Yeah, it had really cute characters. So, excellent book for kids that maybe middle school-aged kids that can be reading it on their own. I wouldn't recommend it as a read aloud if you want to enjoy it yourself. So if you like to read the books that your 11-year-old reads, check it out. You might enjoy this too. If you've read this already, let us know in the comments. We'd love to hear what you thought of it.
And if you are enjoying Book Buds, please like our page.
And share us with your friends.
And subscribe to our channel, Book Buds!
Caw! Caw! Caw!
It's just a bird pawing. It's totally not funny.
Ready?
Yep.